Hello everybody and welcome once again to Running Red. So I've been a bit busy, but let's have a look. First of all, let's have a look at these two. If you remember rightly, I put the ender lily seed on some end stone, and this is already mature, and this one is still only 86%. So let's do this again. In fact, it's probably worthwhile doing this one, see if this catches up. So that's quite an achievement. Next thing I want to do, and let's get away from those noisy mobs for a second. I think probably not need to grind those, so we'll take this resident tank off here. I want one ender pearl. They're very noisy as well. Oh, they're dreadful. That's what I want. So let's just grind a few of these guys anyway while we're here. I want to get to about 40 XP anyway, so. Right, I think that's about the lot. Oh no, there's a creeper up there. Right, I don't really need to wait for the creeper to come down. I don't want the ender pearl, as I've got everything on. Oh, the creeper's come down now. Let's go. What did I just press? I must have pressed something different. I don't see anybody else, and that's good. Anyway, let's just check. Nothing else I don't want in here. Good. Right. So now we've got this ender pearl, I wanted to basically see if it works. Oh, not the ender pearl, I'm talking about this thing. Teleposition focus. Because it's supposed to work across dimensions if the dimension is chunk loaded or still loaded. Let's have a quick look. First thing to do is to get on this one. I'll make sure my jetpack is off, otherwise it does strange things. Click that one. There we go. And what I'm hoping for is this is actually working. Oh, it is. It's a great stuff. What I've got in here now is a spawner. And this is a spawner. And a grinder. So this is now, it's actually spawning skeletons. It should be a wither skeleton it's spawning. That's why we've got some coal and some wither skeleton stuff here and some swords. Now also I built a way around the passageway all the way around here so you can sort of walk all the way around, and I also built a service layer. So let's go and have a look at this service layer. First of all, that's easy enough to get down to. We just go down these ladders here, if I get onto them, which I think I have, and then just walk out here. Oops. There we go. So what I've got here is a tesseract, which is the one I built last time, configured to grinder, and that is sending items and it's receiving energy and fluids. So hopefully it's getting the essence from the other grinder. It might have run out by now actually, because I haven't checked that. And this one here is, from this grinder. This grinder should have in it, which I can't reach from here, so let's go back up the stairs. And it was quite straightforward building the service layer. I also did is I enabled the jetpack and then put four blocks of stone down, and that's where I started my floor from. So if I go in here, take the risk. It's got no more essence in there, so it's stopped getting essence from the base. So I need to basically get some more essence. Now this one should have essence in here. Yes, it's got plenty of essence. So what I want to do is to take this essence and try and feed that into the other tesseract. I'm not quite sure how I want to do that yet, because I suppose the easiest way would be to do it from the side, but should be okay, I think. Let's try doing that. So, oh, by the way, before I forget, I want to set this one up here, didn't I? To right-click this on there, so it's now. Let's have a look at that one. So it's now owned and it's dimensioned, so that's fine. Let's see if we can do this. So what I need to do is to go down here twice, I think. Maybe here. And then we can go down here. And out here so I can get in the place. In fact, I might as well turn this thing on as well. So pick up everything that we've dropped. So now I should be able to, hopefully, take this fluid duct. We'll take the opaque fluid duct, because nowadays that's pretty straightforward to build. And get the right one, select it, and then bring this down the bottom here. So that's now feeding fluid out. Of course, I can come back in again now here and seal off this bit from the outside. Hopefully, I only need to do this. I'm just not 100% sure at the moment, so we'll see. So anyway, it's safe from this side so they can't get out. I still got my jetpack on. It's funny how this is disabled. It's funny how when you're in the nether, the heart canisters don't seem to be working properly. Right, that's great. So now we need to get that into the spawner. Now that might be a bit difficult. Let's just see if we can do it. Hopefully. Oops. Yes, it went up too much, didn't it? Actually, this is just a slab, isn't it? I put on the top. Let's just put one slab back on there. If I can reach. Get the right position. Slab. Oh, doesn't help when I'm doing that. There you go. So now I should be able to bring this fluid duct here into this like that, and one down. Okay, that's receiving. I don't need this one on, so let's remove that. Oh, wrong window. This is the one I want. Crescent hammer, let's just right click it a couple of times. So that should now be going the right direction, but you'll notice here it's got nothing. Actually, probably doesn't matter. Let's have a look on here if we can actually get to this. Take this out and see if we can click on there. Yes, now it's working. You see, it's now got doing some idle stuff. It's got energy and it's got some mob essence. So it's now grounding and it's working. So that's good. What I'm hoping for, of course, is some wither skeleton skulls. It won't have enough, but we can turn on the other one just later on. You see here, it seems to be working happily. So, let's go back home. Jetpack is off, isn't it? Let me just check. Now it is. Task completed. So what we can do, I've got quite a lot of essence in these tanks here, and at the moment it's being sent out. So maybe what we could do is to feed that back into this tesseract as a store. It's just an idea. I'm not sure if this is going to work or not. Let's just try it. So if we take this fluid duct here, 5 should be enough. Let's turn the jetpack on and put it on top of the tank there. Because this is an output tank, I think may work. Let's turn these off. And go up again. What I need to do now is to install a servo into here. Like that. Take this out, and of course now we need to come along and to make sure that flow is going out. There we go. How about that? So now that's flowing into the tesseract. and it's also flowing out of the tesseract here. It should be actually configured that way, but it seems to work anyway. Okay, good. So now the spawner and the another should be getting plenty of essence. Now all we need to do now, of course, is to turn this one back on again. Oops, wrong way, wrong one. How often have I done that? I can't tell you. Now, hopefully this is working. It's difficult to tell sometimes. Should be getting power. It is. And it's doing some ticking, so that's good too. Of course, the disadvantage, as I said before, I will not get any blood in this altar, but there's plenty of blood around anyway. And I also don't kill the mobs for the diamond reward, which is a shame. But, can't have everything. And it's eating time again, by the looks of it. So much eating. 57. Right, 62. Full. So I'm just got to now wait until we get some wither skeleton skulls. At least we need at least 12, I think. So that's going to take some time to do, and hopefully the essence will be generating enough of it. So the next thing I want to do is I want to set up a Tinker's Construct, because I'd like to get one of those Tinker's Construct knapsacks that go and a belt, these two items. And for that I need some tough rods, I think aluminium tough rods. So the first thing I'm going to do is to make a crusher, which is this one. And that's made from the Mekanism Crusher. And I want a circuit control, which is enriched alloy. The enriched alloy is basically one iron ingot in a metallurgic infuser. Should give me one of these. So let's go and get that first of all. Two iron ingots, that's all I need. And I did build that metallurgic infuser, I think. And that's this thing here. Let's put those two iron ingots in there. And it needs some redstone. And at the moment, I have plenty of redstone. I think it's here. Oh. Oh, that's the energetic infuser. It must be. Here we go. I'm not sure how much we need. Let's put in a couple. That makes an interesting noise as well. It's obviously got, I don't know much about mechanism. Let's see, we have our two enriched alloys. Actually, I only need two, that's perfect. So now we need some redstone around these. Get around my machines, of course, another problem. So if I remember rightly, it's just two like that, and we have these two printed circuit controls. So that means now we've got to get the steel casing, which is one osmium ingot and four steel. I think I still have some steel. If not, we'd have to make some. Yes, I've got five steel. And this thing, if I remember, is made with... can't remember what it's made with, let's have a look. I think it's made with lead and iron and water. Okay, so lead and iron, and I am full inventory again. So I can get rid of some of this stuff, so let's put away these. We don't need these for the time being. Should have left those in the nether, they're more useful there anyway, so. And also I can get rid of, at the moment, this stuff, so I don't need any conduits or servos or resident tanks. I'll leave those here as well. Right, so we got lead, we need a bucket of water, which we've got plenty of, and iron, wasn't it? Iron ingot, okay. So I might have the recipe for this already set up. Let's have a look. Yes, I do. Put that in there, and one lead and one iron. And here we have our osmium ingot. Let's take that recipe out of there. We don't need it in there forever. Let's come back to here, and then we have our machine frame, I think. Yay. So now, let's go back again, and debugger's lava, no big deal. So we've got these two. Four redstone. There's redstone in here, anyway. One of those, and now we just need two buckets of lava. And do I have any buckets in there? Yes. Okay, let's take those out of there like this. And I shall show you a trick. Let's go to our little lava pool. This is just here visible. That's that one and that's that one. And now these are in positions 4 and 5 on my numeric keypad. So when I right click this here and move up here and press 4, that will take the fourth item out of my inventory. And the same for this one. So now we have a crusher. And we get our buckets back again, which is also good. Put those up there. And we can go and install this crusher right beside the metallurgic infuser because we've got plenty of power. Now that should also have energy in it. So all we need now is some cobblestone. Cobblestone we have plenty of. I've got smooth stone we've made at the moment. Let's just change that to back to cobble. And let's put the cobblestone in here. I think this is the recipe. It has this great noises. And we should get out of this gravel. There we go. So in this mod pack, that's the easiest way to make gravel. But I've probably got plenty of gravel elsewhere. Let's go and have a look around here. Wow, look at these trees. Everything's growing to so full. Oops, there's definitely a mob around here again. I wonder if he's coming from the top of the tree. Let's turn the jetpack on. See if we can see him. Well, he's probably down under, so to speak. Let's go and have a look down here. Let's get our weapons ready. Well, I've no idea where he's coming from. There should be no yellow blocks around here. Let's just press F7. Because this is all half slab, so on the bottom half the slab. Unless he's spawning below here, which I don't think he could be. But there is definitely a zombie around somewhere. No idea where he is, but you can definitely hear him. Let's go and have a look down here. Is he spawning in this tree somewhere? Well, it doesn't really worry me at the moment. I have no idea where he is. Sounds like he's coming from here. He could be in these trees, but, well, if he is, he'll die, so that's no big deal. What did I want to do? Gravel, that was right. So we need plenty of clay and plenty of gravel. Wrong chest, of course. We've got 46 gravel in here and plenty of clay. Let's take two stacks of those. Let's take three stacks, actually, because we need to make grout. And the recipe for grout is actually quite straightforward. We can make a... Let's have a look what the recipe for grout is, because I have forgotten. It's this stuff. Ah, yes, it's sand, gravel and clay. So we've got plenty of sand, too. Did I pick any sand up from back there? Just again, no, I didn't. Let's take a couple of these because we've got plenty of those, and of course, we can make sand these days. So the recipe is we can do, I suppose, we can do it the easy way, as it were. Let's make 47 in this case. That may be enough, in fact. No, probably not. We have to make quite a lot of these things. We need another 17 gravel. Let's go and get another 17 gravel. We got 21 already. Let's take those out of there. Come back to this. Let's take the gravel. Where is it now? There we go. So we ended up with 4 gravel. Actually, I can put the servos away for the matter as well. I was just thinking then, there are some hidden quests, and I've done 2 of them because I knew what they were already. So let's just go back. So this one is going to be fairly soon, so we can do that in a second. Now let's go back here. Let's go to drowning lessons. I've got 2 quests available for completion. This one here, kill them with flowers. And the first thing you have to do is to make some rose red and some dandelion yellow, and as a return we'll get 5 hearts. Now that you have to make the rose red and the dandelion in your own inventory. So you basically just take a flower and hold it and grind it, like, I'll show you what I mean. So you have plenty of dandelions from the bees. Where is that mob? Let's just do this away out of here. So when you do this, you basically do it like that, and that's how you do it. If you do it using the pulverizer, it does not work. We'll plant this flower back here. No big deal. So, now we have done that, yes, I need you to make one. All you have to do to make this is then it's one piece of wood, I think. Which I don't have it on me. Let's just take some wood out of here. Okay, go back to the book. I don't think it matters what wood you need. Oak planks, it does. Okay, fine. Not in there. I got some oak planks in here. No, I got some oak wood. Let's just do those. In fact, let's do that the proper way. The old fashioned way. I didn't think I'd have to do this again. And let's just simply put these into here. See, they're getting quite nicely grounded here, so we can help it along a bit with the, I don't want the bones or the skeleton, the arrows, because I've got plenty. Right, there we go. Oh, I only put one in, didn't I? Yes. Actually, one's fine. I need 2. Let's do another one. In fact, with it interestingly here, I'll show you this. With the hopper, I can do it with the hopper as well. But you'll notice the hopper's not getting filled up at the moment because it's turned off. As soon as I turn it on again, things will then fall into it, so to speak. I can remove that and then turn it off, and the thing will go in or out of it. So now we've got plenty of wood. Let's go to the book. And I can collect the reward, which is five hearts. So all I have to do is submit this to the QDS. And the QDS is over here. So let's put it in the hopper. We just need one of those in the hopper. Now it should have worked. Alright, claim reward. That's one. And the other one was this one, bury me in black. It's a fucking death wish. So we have to make some black wool, some black carpet, some stained glass black, and some stained glass panes. And they're fairly straightforward too. The only difference was, I think, is this. For the ceramic dye, you have to make the ceramic dye, and the recipe for that is clay. And my printer's being noisy again, I just have to turn it off. Right, and you get 4 dyes, and then you can then dye the glass like that. so you end up with panes in glass, which is fine. So again, it's the same thing, you just submit it. Let's just submit another oak block. Oh, I think I did the wrong one last time, didn't I? The manual submit, yes, have a look. Manual submit, claim reward. And another one of these is, well, they're so noisy, is this thing, a basic energy cube. If you make that, it's supposed to work, but I think it needs to be, you need to have something different about it. I'm not exactly sure what. It's the only, it doesn't work. It needs to be empty, no charge in there, but I'm wondering if it has something like a cell inside it, because I'll show you what I'm talking about. Let's just take it. In fact, I don't need the hearts with me anyway, so let's put that here. And this thing. Ah, yes, in fact, it showed you that. If I press, well, look at it and press shift, it says inventory false. If I put something in it, then the inventory will be true, and maybe that triggers it, I'm not sure. Anyway, we ended up with 10 hearts, which I'm going to put in here in case I need them to add to my two that I've already got. But let's just sort that so no one knows either. Okay, good. Now, those hidden quests are now done, and what do we need? In fact, look at this now. It does seem to be working because that level's gone down, and hopefully it's also coming out of here, but maybe not. It doesn't seem to be coming into here. But anyway, we'll see what happens. I'll just take it off. Right, back to our grout, weren't we? We're going to cook some grout up. So we need some bricks. Here we go, redstone furnace. So we got 128 grout. Let's put 64 in there and 64 in here. Let's sort that out. And let's put the rest of the stuff in this chest here. So you're only getting them to have to quite a few grout. I'm going to need quite a lot. Obsidian, not the right place for obsidian, but sand it'll do. And you see these are seared bricks are coming in nicely now. What we need, let's go and have a look what we actually need. We need some glass as well. So let's look at the uses of these things. So we need a smelter controller first of all, and we also need at least one drain. Okay. Let's have a 7. Oh, I can make a drain, I think. Smeltery drain. And then I get the Mighty Smelter book automatically once you've made the first item. In fact, I might have to wait a bit for these. I've got 10. It's going to take a few. It's going to take a little while to do all of this, so. I'm going to put it somewhere back here. I've extended the platform here a bit. Oh look, some ink. Oh yes, of course I've got the signal on. Let's just see if that actually got anything in here. Funny having a jetpack when you go into the water. I've got all these. Let's get number one. Oh, I need to activate that, don't I? Shift. How's my air doing? Disable the jetpack again. F, so we go down faster. That's all the squids. And I've got 18 ink sacks, which is quite reasonable. I wonder if you ever get a squid trophy. That'll be an interesting. So I'm thinking about putting it here. At the moment, I think it's two layers, and it's also a 9 by 3 by 3 square block, isn't it? No, it's not. Look, it's gonna make that two. Oops, shouldn't have done that quite so drastically. Let's do it like this. Oh, come back and fill this in later on, I think. I'm not going to have enough bricks for this. No. So we can put the smelter here and just put some bricks in the middle of that. So now, with a bit of luck, we'll have some more bricks prepared. 28. What a lot. I've got 40. There we go. So that's working away. So let's make some more of the other parts of the thing. So on the base, we're going to need some, I think it's just bricks. So we're going to need 9 of those. That's 10. 10 will do. We'll start with 10, I think. We'll put those 10 down here. You don't need to put these in the corners either, so. But I like to do that. So that's the base. And on top of the base, for example, we put the controller. Actually, I like putting the controller on the corner. So I'll put it on this corner here. The reason I like to do that is you can then automate a bit. In fact, while those other bricks are cooking, I don't want to wait for them. Another 18, and what have we got in there? None, that's empty, and this has still got 62 in. And this has now got 42 gravel, so let's make some more. Clay and sand, isn't it? So we've got 3 clay in there and no sand. Let's go and get some more. I've got 49 in there. Clay, plenty of. I'll do. Don't need those, and I don't need those. Let's take those out of there and sort that again. Okay. Gravel, clay. And it doesn't matter where you put them, it's unshaped. It's not shaped crafting. We got another 80 odd, 84. Right, I want to go to the nether and I want to test this theory if it works. Let's go up quickly up here. I didn't close the gate, so that's good. Could be a mistake. Make sure the jetpack's disabled. And I did click this one, didn't I? Oh, I am daft. Let's see if this is working. How much have we got anything else in here of interest? Another sword by the looks of it. 6 necrotic bones. 8 arrows. 1 lapis lazuli leggings. Interesting. It just freaked me out going in here, but let's have a quick look at it. Right, plenty of everything, so that's fine. Out there quick, just in case one spawns. It would not be the first time. Let's go up here and they can have a look at this chunk load from chicken chunks. If I show the lasers, it should be including, that's a circle, we can change that to a square, I think, and it's doing base 9 chunks, so that is definitely doing the transposer. If I can land on it. Right, I have to turn off the jetpack. Press the button. Let's go back home. Let's close the gate. So let's put the one in that we did before and see if this works. It bit missed. No, it might be good for transfer bearing other things, but for us it's not working for people. So for instance, I could transfer a chest. Let's just do that as an example. 8 birchwood, perfect. One chest, and let's say take a golden apple or something like that and put it in. Let's put the chest on top of it. That was a shift click, by the way, and put 3 golden apples in. And in fact, we could put the sapphire net reusable with the blaze in it as well, and then send that. And that's definitely gone. And that should now be in the nether. Let's go and have a look. I wonder what will happen if I go to the same place. This side. Well, it worked. So where's that chest gone to? Oh, there. And there we have it. I'm not quite sure where the chest went to, but there we are. I think we can simply go. Yes. The wrong side. And if I click this one, it should come back here. There we go. So that's a good way of getting things to and from the nether if you want to do that. Oh, I've basically run out of time. I do apologize, but we can do a few more bits and pieces with this. We need some more nether bricks. I'm not sure. We need some drains, and we need a... I won't make that one. That's very useful for putting moving liquids about. We need some seared faucets, probably 2 actually. And we need a one of them, which is quite a casting basin, and probably one of these, which is a casting table. We will need. What else do we need? I think it's a window, but I'm not sure what the recipe for a window is. Let me have a look. Just usage. Yes, it's that one. Produces a seared tank. And this is the one. Thickened glass, clear glass, just glass will do. And that gives me a seared window, which is actually quite good. One of those. In fact, we'll make another drain for that matter. So we've got 2 drains. What else do we need? Probably some more bricks. 10. Right, let's go and do this quickly before. Oh, did I put the drain on here? I did, okay. That's not what I want. Let's take this off because it's the wrong place anyway. I need the controller. Did I not build the controller? I didn't. Let's go make the controller first of all. I think the controller is this one, isn't it? Smeltery controller. It is. Let's turn this off. We don't need that on all the time. And then beside the controller, we shall put a tank. Or a seared window. That should work as well, I think. If not, I can always replace it. The seared window is good because you can see watch lava, and you can also see behind it. Now, how am I doing this right? to be honest with you, I've forgotten. What I'll do is I shall come back next time. I hope you've enjoyed this episode. It's getting on just up to 40 minutes. That's long enough. And I'll finish off next time. Until then, bye for now.